A New Jersey community is reeling over the loss of a beloved elementary school teacher and coach who died of coronavirus. Ben Luderer was only 30 years old. He was a special education teacher and a varsity baseball coach. He passed away in his home this week, just a few days after feeling symptoms. Joining us now is Ben's wife, Brandy Luderer. Brandy, what a shock this story is to, of course, you and your family and the entire community. And everything that I've read about Ben is just what a special guy he was.
Yeah, he really was. You know, there are so many different aspects of his life where he has touched so many people, whether it be, you know, just being a son or a husband or a friend, you know, a colleague, a baseball coach, even when he was a baseball player, you know, he's met so many people and touched them in so many ways. It's just hard to believe, you know?
Oh, my God. I mean, we're so sorry that this, I mean, it's horrible on any level. And then the suddenness of this. And so just take us back to just this past Friday night. What happened on Friday night?
So Friday night is when we actually had to go to the ER. He was feeling, you know, shortness of breath and like really struggling to breathe and, you know, was really concerned, and he knew it himself. So he came into our bedroom where I was laying, and he said, you know, I gotta go. I gotta take myself to the hospital. And I said, are you sure you want to go there? You know, like, are you sure? He said, yes, I need to. So I ended up driving him there. You know, at that time they weren't accepting any visitors, so I wasn't able to go in with him, but he was updating me the whole time. I was out sitting in the car, you know, so they gave him oxygen. He responded well to the oxygen. He had fluids and Tylenol. And, you know, they let him go home. They said he was, you know, responding well to the oxygen. Just keep doing what he was doing at home, drink lots of fluid. And he was given, you know, some prescriptions to take. So that's where it ended on Friday.
Okay. And then By Sunday night, he was feeling better. I mean, you say that he got out of bed. He ate dinner for the first time in a while. And then what happened?
So, like you said, Sunday was a great day. He was up moving around, talking to us. And then, you know, nights he had always said were the worst. It was hard to get comfortable. He was, you know, sweating and, you know, when he laid down a certain way, it was hard for him to breathe. So he, texted me because I was out at that point on the couch and he was in the bedroom, you know, trying to get comfortable. And he said, you know, I'm struggling, like this is hard, you know. And I said, well, do you need to go back to the ER? And he was like, you know, I don't know right now. So I just tried to do as much as I could to make him comfortable, you know, calm down his breathing, you know, get him to cool down. I ran out to a friend's house. You know, she was willing to let me borrow the humidifier to kind of, you know, try that as something new because, you know, like I said, the nights were the worst. And he finally settled in after taking his bath. The humidifier was on and he was ready to, like, try the night, you know, go to sleep, you know. So I came back out to the couch and I could hear through the door that he was still breathing and I fell asleep. And then, you know, when I woke up that morning, he wasn't with us anymore.
Oh, my God. Brandy, it's just so shocking. It's just so shocking. You saw him at 2 a.m. and then you woke up at 6 a.m. to go and check on him?
Correct. Yeah.
I mean, Brandy, I feel for you because obviously that is such a shock to the system for anybody, and that you were alone and having to discover him.
Yeah.
What did you do?
I am very my youngest brother lives with us. He goes to Montclair State University, so he's been living with us and going to school and stuff. So I am very fortunate that he's here and I'm not completely alone with everything going on. You know, nobody can come over and visit. But being that he lives with us, he's here to support me and we're here to support each other because, you know, my whole family, Ben's whole family, you know, all the communities that he's been a part of, you know, we're all just trying to get through this, you know, minute by minute, hour by hour and day by day because it's tough.
Of course it is. And the reason that you have to be alone is because you've tested positive for coronavirus.
Correct. I tested positive, you know, a couple of days before Ben started showing symptoms. So I had a very mild case. You know, I only had a low grade, you know, temp. They weren't even considering it a fever, you know, and some nasal congestion. But I was, you know, on the mend, getting better. And then that's when he started showing symptoms. So
have the doctors given you any idea of why a young 30-year-old, healthy, no pre-existing condition, young man declined so suddenly and died?
No, you know, we don't really know. I don't really know.
So I know that you want people to know who your husband was. I mean, I know that he was such a special person and you want all of us to be able to understand it. And so just tell us about his life.
I think from the moment, you know, that he was born, you know, he is adopted. His parents, you know, were very fortunate to, you know, get him into their life, you know, for the 30 years that they had him. They said from day one, you know, he had the biggest smile on his face and, you know, you can see it all the way up for the 30 years, every single picture that he was in, you know, he had a huge smile on his face, from playing baseball to becoming a coach and a teacher and, you know, a husband, a colleague. Every single person, whether he knew you for 5 minutes or he knew you for, you know, his whole entire lifetime, he would give you the same respect and try to reach out and help you and make you laugh in any way possible. You know, that was just the type of selfless person that he was, always worrying about everybody else before himself, you know.
Brandy, when will you be able to be around other people? I mean, are you still self-isolating?
Yeah, just to be safe, you know, with Ben having symptoms so recently, we've just tried to been cleaning up the house and stuff, but I am no longer showing symptoms or anything like that, you know. Now with my brother here, he has not been showing symptoms. We're just trying to make sure that he stays that way, stays healthy.
And Brandy, what's next for you? Do you even know where you'll begin next week?
No, I have no idea. I have no idea where this goes. It's like I said, I'm trying to take it minute by minute, hour by hour, and day by day because, you know, Ben and I were the type of couple that did everything together. You know, as you can see, we have a lot of similarities. We work in the same school district, so we were able to drive to school every day. So it's very hard understanding where to go with this when you don't have your partner in life that you did everything with. So I'm still trying to wrap my head around it.
Brandy, you're just way too young to have this situation. I mean, that's how people in their 80s feel when they lose their partner. And the idea that you have had to deal with this and that it was all so sudden and that you had to find him, it's really heartbreaking. And so we're thinking of you and we're sending our love and we're just hoping that you stay healthy and get all the support you need. We're so sorry for your loss.
I appreciate it. Thank you.